For race day. That's what we're all thinking about, Alyssa.
Yeah, you know, I hope we can maintain that little promise we have in our 7-day forecast where it kind of looks nice going into Carb Day and the Indy 500. Before we get to that, though, 3 confirmed tornadoes in Indiana from yesterday. So 3 of those were confirmed: Johnson County, Shelby County, and Brown County. I'm going to show you where those are located here, just on the south side of the viewing area, on the south edge here. So in EF0, for Johnson County, and EF0 also for Brown County, and EF1 for that Shelby County tornado, where the max winds were estimated to be at 110 miles an hour. And so we have to look at, or the National Weather Service goes out and does the surveying of the damage the day after. And based on that, the winds are estimated. So that's where we get that 110 miles per hour from. And in this area, just wind gusts picked up from weather stations that was over 70 miles an hour. And again, for context, that's where it is in relation to Indianapolis. So we did get 3 confirmed tornadoes from those severe thunderstorms that were warned over the weekend. Looking at storm reports, they're not popping up. They might populate in a second here, but there was a ton of them all along the south edge of I-70 here and extending well outside of Indiana. Most of this going to be wind damage. That's what we saw over the weekend. Lots of trees on the roads and down power lines. 56 degrees right now in Indianapolis. Things are feeling much better now after that cold front's passed through, and we've got some comfortable dry air. 36 degrees is the dew point temperature, so very comfortable weather here. Much lower on our high temperatures than we've been lately, with those near 90s and near record high temperatures. The normal for today, 75, and finally we went close to 10 degrees below that normal high temperature. It's been a minute since we've been there. The winds have now calmed down overall today. We've gusted just over 20 miles an hour, so everything is starting to calm down, and this is the weather that we're going to be looking at over the next couple of days. Just inheriting this dry weather with sunshine as we head into Monday and Tuesday. Our next best chance for storms is not going to be until Wednesday. So we hope it kind of stays in that Wednesday to Thursday range right now. You can tell that cold front worked on our temperatures and brought us down into the mid-50s now. We're going to be heading into cooler temperatures overnight. And then in the morning, we can get close, brushing near upper 40s, but we'll kind of hang out there right around 50 degrees for the low temperatures, and then rebounding near 70 throughout the day tomorrow. Looking ahead on our future view, there's not a whole lot to see in the next couple of days. We've got cloudy skies in and out for the next few days here, both Monday and Tuesday, and then our next best chance of storms is not going to be all the way until Wednesday. I've got this just playing through dry weather conditions, and then you start to see where Wednesday we can get some showers and thunderstorms coming back into the mix, and then hopefully it kind of stays that way into that Wednesday Thursday zone. And it looks like we could be drying out for Carb Day, so I'm going to put this all the way on our 7-day forecast so we can have plenty of time to talk about it here. Temperatures in the mid 70s for both Tuesday and Wednesday. So we do warm up. We've got a nice rebound, but there's that pair of storm days coming up for the middle part of the week, and I think we've got some good weather. We'll just pray this kind of hangs on here as we head into the weekend, because it looks like we could be dry heading into that Indy 500.
All right, Alyssa, thanks. If you saw that Sunday, if we can just hold on for that weather, Alexa.
Alyssa,
that would be nice.
I'm looking at you. Yeah. I'm looking at you.
I hope so, you guys. I want to deliver.
I'm looking at you.
The pressure's on now, so know that.
Because coming up in sports, we are exactly 1 week away from the Indianapolis 500, and we had some historically fast speed today. I'll have everything from pulled in.